Welcome back, everyone. The second lesson, Classical Cryptography, will continue an overview of historic tools of secret communication. In this lesson, you will learn about codes, ciphers, and the enemy knows the system principle. In the previous lesson, you have learned about steganographic methods that conceal the fact of secret communication. Cryptographic methods, on the other hand, do not hide the existence of a secret message, but its content. One class of cryptographic methods is codes. In literature and popular culture, the words code and cipher have been often used interchangeably, but this course will distinguish them. A code is a simple replacement of letters, syllables, words, whole phrases or concepts with code words, code numbers, or other symbols. Like, for example, this code table used by Mary Queen of Scots or Knights Templar. Historically, codes often operated on the level of meaning of the message rather than individual letters. For example, a telegram saying the corn crops are nearing harvest could have meant a signal to action for a partisan group. Codes also generally do not involve mathematical transformations to the plain text, unlike ciphers. As in the case of steganography, when using codes, all parties need to agree to the methods and meanings of symbols beforehand for the communication to be successful. Ciphers, however, operate on a lower level of message structures, historically letters, nowadays bits, and utilize some defined set of mathematical operations. An illegible sequence of letters or bits produced by encryption transformation is called the ciphertext. Most ciphers use a secret key to make ciphertext unintelligible to anyone but those who possess the key. In case of one famous historical example, the Caesar cipher, the encryption transformation would be, for each letter of the plain text, add X to its index in the alphabet and write down the letter at that position in the alphabet where X is the secret key. Caesar himself is believed to have used 3 as the key, so in his case it would be A plus 3 would result in D, B plus 3 in E, and so on for each letter of the Latin alphabet. You can try it yourself with this implementation from Wolfram Function repository. The decryption transformation is for each letter of the ciphertext, subtract X from its index in the alphabet and write down the letter in that position of the alphabet, like this. There is a defining and unifying feature to all the different techniques of secret communication used until the early 20th century. Encryption and decryption were performed by hand, rarely with the use of intricate mechanical devices like this wheel cipher device invented by Thomas Jefferson. This several millennia-long period in the history of cryptography is characterized by algorithms being invented by humans, for use by humans with pen and paper, with computation a human can easily perform in their mind, and to protect secret messages against the analytical abilities of a human brain. However, there is a fundamental principle distinguishing the novel cryptography after the 19th century. A cryptosystem should be secure even if every detail about the system, except the key, is public knowledge. As a physical analog, imagine an ordinary resettable combination lock. The structure of the lock is available to anyone who wishes to purchase one, but the combination is chosen and set by the owner. If the owner suspects that the combination has been revealed, he can easily reset it without replacing the physical mechanism. This principle for the design of cryptographic protocols was originally stated by August Kirchhoff in 1883. It outlines a major advantage of cryptography over steganography, which was common in the 19th century for hiding the meaning of military messages, and dictates to avoid relying on security through obscurity. Another famous formulation of the same principle is "the enemy knows the system" by Claude Shannon in 1949. Kirchhoff's principle and later Shannon's maxim have imprinted the paradigm shift in how secret communication algorithms are designed and reasoned about, gradually gaining recognition throughout the 19th and 20th centuries. As of now, the majority of modern cryptography makes use of publicly known algorithms, and the security of the communication resides only in the key chosen. For information security in general, this also implies that the fewer and the simpler are the secrets one must keep to maintain system security, the easier it is to ensure system security. In the next lesson, you will learn about modern cryptography that relies on Kirchhoff's principle.